Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, we will see how to group and filter the items of Syncfusion's Blazor Autocomplete component. Looking at this example, you can see the autocomplete component displaying different vegetable names, grouped under different categories like leafy and salad, beans, and bulb and stem. You can filter vegetable names that match the characters typed. Now, I will show you how to group and filter autocomplete items using the Blazor Autocomplete Getting Started application. Let me open the existing Blazor application, where I have added the Blazor Autocomplete component with vegetable names data source. If you would like to watch the video on the basics of adding a Blazor Autocomplete component, follow the link provided in the card. You can also find a reference link in the description below. Now, I will run this example by pressing F5. Here is the autocomplete component showing vegetable names. Now, let me show you the steps to group these autocomplete items. First, I will modify the existing data source by defining one more field, category, with appropriate values. Then, I will map this newly defined data source field name, category to the group by option, within this autocomplete code. When you look at the autocomplete component, data items are grouped under leafy and salad, beans, and bulb and stem categories. Here, by default, the data items are filtered based on the characters typed in the search box and starts with filter type applied to autocomplete. To filter data based on ends with or contains filter types, use filter type property. Now, I am going to filter items based on end characters. So, let me define filter type property with the value ends with inside the autocomplete code. When I type some characters here, you can see the pop-up showing vegetable names that end with my typed-in characters. Similarly, you can also apply contains filter type to filter data items that contain your typed-in characters at any position. By default, the casing of the typed-in characters is ignored during the filtering action on autocomplete, but for the characters to have the same casing, set the ignoreCase property to false. As you can see, when I start typing some characters in the lower case, there are no matching items found. Okay, finally I will show you how to specify the filter suggestion item count of the autocomplete component. Here, I have planned to display two data items in the suggestion pop-up, so let me define suggestion count and set its value as 2. So here, you can see when I type in the characters, the autocomplete control displays two data items in the suggestion pop-up that matches the typed-in characters. Okay, let me summarize. We have seen how to group the Blazor autocomplete items as well as how to filter them. Also, we have seen the filter types supported in autocomplete component and how to apply them. If you would like to see the working example of the autocomplete in this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Blazor products through our community license. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.